Good morning, Masinloc Zambales. Good morning to our beloved learners from Grade 8. You are listening to Servisyong Putog, DWSP 101.5 News FM. This is your on-air teacher, Teacher Jelly Marila. Yours truly is from Bamban National High School. I will facilitate you in maximizing your participation as you learn today's lesson. Welcome to Math 8 class, a new venture in learning, multiplying, and dividing rational algebraic expressions. This morning, make sure that you are all on your comfortable seats and properly listening to our broadcast. At this moment, please get your learning activity sheets. You can also get your notebook and ballpen to take down notes about the lesson that I am going to discuss. Whether you go by the boat, by car, or by plane, traveling can be a lot of fun. It is also very educational as it gives you first-hand experiences about things you just see on TV or read in the papers or in books. But do you realize how many mathematical concepts can be involved in traveling? For example, do you know how far you can reach by a bus if it is traveling 37 over 2 km per hour for 1/4 of an hour? So, our lesson for today is about multiplying and dividing rational algebraic expressions. At the end of this lesson, you are expected to multiply rational algebraic expressions and divide rational algebraic expressions. Rational algebraic expressions are multiplied the same way as you would multiply regular fractions. So, let us recall multiplication of fractions. Let's take this as an example. 4 over 5 times 2 over 3. Remember that we will just multiply both numerator then both denominators as well. So, the answer is? Yes, correct! 8 over 15. The concept of multiplying the numerators and the denominators of fractions also applies to multiplying rational algebraic expressions. There are methods also of reducing the product into its lowest forms. Multiplying rational algebraic expressions and methods of reducing the product in lowest form will be discussed using series of examples. The first two examples will be using monomials to illustrate multiplication of rational algebraic expressions. Now, I want you to look at your module on page 5. Please listen attentively. Here we go. Let us first study the different methods and steps on multiplying rational algebraic expressions. The first method is divide out greatest common monomial factor or GCMF after multiplying. Let's take this as an example. 37x over 2y times y over 4. First thing to do is to multiply the numerators and denominators of the given rational algebraic expressions. So, let's multiply the numerators. 37x times y is equal to 37xy. And then, multiply the denominators. 2y times 4 is equal to 8y. Step 2 is to find the GCMF of the product of numerators and denominators. In our example, 37xy, look for the prime factors of 37, x, and y. What are the prime factors of 37, x, and y? Correct! 37xy. Now, look for the prime factors of the denominator, which is 8y. Correct! The prime factors of 8y are 2 times 2 times 2 times y. And then, next is to look for the common factors or GCF from the two groups of factors. So, the GCF is, yes, right, y is the GCF. And then, after that, step 3 is to divide out the GCMF of the product of numerators and denominators. 37xy over 8y. So, we will divide out or cancel out the GCF, which is y. The answer is 37x over 8. Last step is to simplify the remaining factors. In this case, 37x over 8 is in its reduced form. So our final answer is 37x over 8. That's the first method on multiplying rational algebraic expressions. Let us now study the second method, which is called divide out greatest common monomial factor or GCMF before multiplying. Let's have this example. X minus 5 over x squared minus 7x plus 10 times x squared plus x minus 6 over 5. In this method, the first step is to find the GCMF of the numerators and denominators. Let's take a look at the numerator first. X minus 5 times x squared plus x minus 6. In this case, we need to factor the trinomial x squared plus x minus 6 first. In our previous lesson, we have already discussed factoring trinomials, right? Now, what is the factor of the trinomial x squared plus x minus 6? That's right, x plus 3 and x minus 2. Then, retain the other factor, which is x minus 5. Now, let's have the denominator. X squared minus 7x plus 10 times 5. Same with the numerator, factor first the trinomial x squared minus 7x plus 10. The factors are, yes, x minus 5 and x minus 2. Then, retain the other factors, which is 5. After that, look for common factors or GCF from the numerators and denominators. The common factors are x minus 5 and x minus 2. Next step is to divide out the GCMF of the numerators and denominators. Let us list all the factors of the numerator as well as the denominator, then divide out or cancel out the common factors of numerator and denominator. Then, simplify the remaining factors. So, the final answer is x plus 3 over 5. Is that clear? Always remember, in multiplying rational algebraic expressions, either before or after multiplying, always divide out the common factors to attain the product in reduced form. We are done with the multiplication of rational algebraic expressions. Now, let us study our second lesson, which is division of rational algebraic expressions. In order for you to understand this lesson, make sure that you also understand our lesson in multiplication of rational algebraic expressions. Do you think dividing rational algebraic expressions is also the same with dividing fractions? The rules for dividing rational algebraic expressions is the same as the rule of dividing fractions. So, let's have a review on dividing fractions first. Let's have our example number 1. If you have 1 over 7 divided by 4 over 6, so, what are we going to do to get the answer on these fractions? Do you remember reciprocal? Reciprocal means it's multiplicative inverse. We need to get the reciprocal of our divisor, which is 4 over 6. Get the reciprocal of it so it will become 6 over 4. Then, proceed to multiplication, wherein we are going to multiply numerator by numerator, then denominator by denominator. Therefore, the answer is 6 over 28 or 3 over 14. To help you understand how to divide rational algebraic expressions, examine this example. X plus y over x minus y divided by x over y. What are the steps we need to follow? Step 1. Determine the dividend and divisor of the expression. In this example, x plus y over x minus y is our dividend and x over y is the divisor. Step 2. Find the reciprocal of the divisor. Reciprocal means its multiplicative inverse. Therefore, the reciprocal of x over y is, yes, correct, y over x. Step 3. Multiply the dividend with the reciprocal of the divisor. So, x plus y over x minus y times y over x. Multiply numerator with numerator. X plus y times y is equal to xy plus y squared. Then multiply the numerator x minus y times x is equal to x squared minus xy. Thus, the quotient in reduced form is y squared plus xy over x squared minus xy. Let's have another example. 3p squared plus 6p plus 3 over p plus 1 divided by 3 over p. So, again, what is the first step we need to follow? That's right! Step 1 is to determine the dividend and divisor of the expression. In this example, 3p squared plus 6p plus 3 over p plus 1 is the dividend and 3 over p is the divisor. Next step is to find the reciprocal of the divisor. Therefore, 3 over p becomes p over 3. Next is to multiply the dividend with the reciprocal of the divisor. But in this case, we can factor the trinomial 3p squared plus 6p plus 3 as 3 times p plus 1 times p plus 1. Then, this will become the result. 3p plus 1 times p plus 1 over p plus 1 times P over 3. So we can divide out or cancel out the GCMF of greatest common monomial factor. Then, simplify the remaining factors. So the quotient in its reduced form is P squared plus 1. Is it clear now? So, that is how to solve multiplication and division of rational algebraic expressions. Let me discover whether you have attained the learning competency from your learning activity sheet on dividing and multiplying rational algebraic expressions through the outputs you will be submitting. You will always bear in mind that there are better things than getting high scores. What is important is you learn from your mistakes and become better learner at the end. Our dear parents, your guidance can make a difference on how well your children can accomplish the learning task. Kindly provide assistance. Thank you. If you have questions, just message your math teachers. I am sure they could help you. I know you can do it, learners. God bless in answering your learning activity sheets. Once again, this is your radio teacher, Teacher Jelly Marila, together with the scriptwriter for this radio broadcast in mathematics, Teacher Eileen Chris M. Pustor, and with the guidance of our school head, Sir Ricky Iyala of Bamban National High School. Goodbye everyone and have a good day!